Hi, hello. Welcome to Jyoti Classes. Today we are going to discuss about rank correlation. What is rank correlation? Where we use? How do we use? Okay, that is what we are going to discuss here. Problems we will be doing for the next videos. You can see the problems. All the types of problems we will be solving. Okay, fine. Now let us know what is rank correlation. Rank correlation, why it is needed. Okay, usually when you can hear the word ranks, don't tell me in the school classes, the attendant will forget about that. Okay, we will discuss something differently. See the beauty contest, or you might be seeing the reality shows nowadays more and more. You can see in the TVs also. Everywhere reality shows are common, right? Dance competitions will be there, singing competitions will be there. Okay, there are so many things. I take example of singing competitions. Okay, when you take singing competition, how do the judge give marks? You won't see single judge over there. Obviously, 2-3 judges will be there. They will be fighting, they will be discussing. So many things will be there. Sometimes we can see 5 judges also, right? Okay, how do they give the judges? Each one will be having different kind of approaches. If you take like that, if I am there, I will be thinking like, okay, fine, it is a singing competition. Okay, the participant who is singing, he is not from this place. He is from a different place. Okay, the participant who is singing, he is not from this place. The program is conducted in Bangalore. In the Bangalore, in the sense, more they have to sing Kannada songs, correct? But the singer, the participant is from a different place. He is from Bombay, okay? Or else he is from Mumbai. He is from Mumbai. So will he be knowing Kannada? No, he doesn't know Kannada. So he will be learning and he will be singing. So that positiveness will be there in my mind. I will be thinking like, okay, even though a small mistake, maybe that much fluency they may not be having. Okay, one or two mistakes, even if it gone also, I feel like, okay, let me give marks. There are some people, when you are joining the competition, you must be very, very careful. Even though it is a small mistake, I will not give marks. Okay, understood? So what I decided, okay, fine. Somehow he learned and he presented very well. Only one mistake, let me leave it. But some of them, they will be thinking, no, he must be perfect. Some of them must be lenient. So like that, the marks will be differing. The marks will be differing. So once they give the marks, then we have to find out, are they thinking in the same way? The approach between both the judges is positively or negatively. They both are thinking in the same way or they are not thinking in the same way. That you will be learning from this rank correlation. Okay? Now, whether judges are giving the ranks, judges will give the ranks? No, they don't give the rank. They just give the marks. They will be giving the marks. Some of them, what they will do, even though they committed the mistake, they will be seeing only one thing. How is the presentation? Some of them, they doesn't care about the presentation. Just only singing I will hear. I don't care how they are presenting, how they are speaking, they are dancing in between the tunnel, I don't care. I need only sung the song correctly or not. If it is not correct, I will not give marks. If he sang correctly, then only I will give marks. That is the way they will be having. Okay, now here I have taken 3 judges. Judge 1 is there, judge 2 is there, judge 3 is there. Okay, judge 1 is there, judge 2 is there, judge 3 is there. Singers I have A, B, C, D. 4 singers are there. A, B, C and D. 4 singers are there, 3 judges are there. How they have given the marks? One has given 70 marks, one has given 80 marks, one has given 95 marks. For B, they have given 75. 62, 81, and then for D they have given 56. He felt very good, 95, and he has given in the middle 78. Okay, for the D here, for judge one, how many marks will you just guess and tell me how many marks I am gonna mark here. If you guess correctly, you just mention in the comment box. Okay, What is the marks I am gonna give here in this place for D, judge one? If you can guess correctly, at least in the range, if you guess correctly, please mention in the comment box. So now I am giving here 62. Okay. And for the judge 2, they have given 78. Judge 3 has given 51 marks. Okay, already I have asked you one question. Please remember that and post the answers in the comments. Now, how to give the ranks to these marks? How will you give the ranks to these marks? How will you give? Last in first or first in last? Whoever scored highest, they will be the first person. Who scored highest, they will be treated as first. Okay, now for the judge one, I am giving ranks. I am giving rank to the judge one. So, who scored highest? 75 scored highest. 72nd. 62 third. 56 is fourth. Understood how to give the ranks? For judge two, how we are giving the ranks? 95 first. 82nd. 78 third. 62 is fourth. Clear? Now, judge 3, how we are giving ranks for judge 3? 95 first, 81 second, 78, 3, 51, 4. Check the ranks clearly. How we got the ranks? Judge 1 felt B is the topper. Judge 3 felt A is the topper. But judge 2 felt C is the topper. Are they going with the smooth approach? Is it a positive approach or negative approach? Both are thinking in the same way or not? How do we know? With one rank we can't decide. So what we will be doing? By taking under consideration of all the ranks, we will take down the formula and then you will substitute in the formula. Okay? So to find out rank correlation, the formula is 1 minus 6 summation d square divided by n cube minus n. Okay, n already everyone knows, number of participants. Okay, number of observations are called n. Then what is this d? What is this d? D means first, at a time you can't find out the correlation between all the three judges. What we will be doing, we will split them. First, I will find between 1 and 2. After that, I will find between 2 and 3. And again, I will find between 1 and 3. Got it? First, find between 1 and 2. 2 and 3. And then 1 and 3. Got it? So, now, how to find out D? D means any rank, any judge you take. First, I am taking judge 1. Judge 1 ranks minus judge 2 rank. Okay? If I am doing for judge 2 and judge 3, again D will be judge 2 minus judge 3. If I am doing between judge 1 and judge 3, then again D will be judge 1 minus judge 3. Okay, then I got D. But in the formula, I have D square. So what I will do now, whatever answer I am getting here, the square I will do the summation of that and then find out, substitute in the formula and find out what is the correlation between judges. Got it? Okay. Now, next question. One more doubt. Obviously, I think you have to get. I don't know whether you are thinking or not. If two people got the same marks, that time what to do? Right? Don't you get that kind of doubt? Any of you got? Please raise the hand in the comments. Raise the hand and mention yes, even I got the doubt. Okay? Whether you got the doubt that if two people got the same marks, then how to give the rank? Right? Judge 1, judge 2 and judge 3. Okay? Marks 35, 49, 62 and 49. Now for judge 2, 38, 71, 62, 37. judge 3. Okay, fine. Judge 2 is enough. 2 judges we will take. Okay, fine. Judge 3 also I will give by 2. 42. 67, 42, 78. Okay, now how to give the marks? Actually, I asked you one more question. First question was, you have to guess and tell me what was the number I was about to write in the first judge's matter. And the second one, what I asked you, whether you got the doubt that if two ranks were repeated, what to do? Correct? Yes. So if you got, please mention in the comment box. Now here, let us give the ranks. So how to give the ranks? Who is the highest? I have given. Now, second rank, I just missed with two people. Okay, here one got 49, one got 49. To whom I should give? So what I will do? Here second, here third. Correct? So 2 plus 3 divided by 2. 2.5. For both of them I am giving 2.5. Okay. Now here it will be fourth one. Now come here. There is no rank repeated. So same 1, 2, 3, 4 will come. Okay. Come to the judge 3. 1, 2. Here 42 repeated 2 times. So 3 and 4. How will you take? 3 plus 4 divided by 2, 3.5. So write down 3.5. When you are writing the formula, again formula will change, substitution will change. In the first question, in the first, just in the introduction itself, you doesn't require to know so much. Okay, just learn how to give the ranks, how to substitute in the formula. And already I have given you two questions, whether you got the same kind of doubt, if two ranks were same, two marks were same, how to give the ranks. And one more thing, how to, whether really you guessed the correct number, at least nearby, at least nearby if you guess, please mention in the comment box. For the first time, if you are watching the video, please like it, share it and subscribe it. Okay, thank you very much. Bye bye. Take care. See you.